morning, YouTubers. I'm glad you're here. Happy Friday. Today is February 17th, 2023. There was a magnitude 6.2. USGS said it was a 6.1 earthquake near Tola, Indonesia. 8 people sent in reports to USGS saying they felt it. Some reports were sent in to EMSE about 408 miles south from where the earthquake occurred. This person said it was a slight earth tremor, and it says Rapid Creek NT. Somewhere there in Australia, another report from Australia, Darwin, small shake followed by a longer shake, 664 kilometers. So that would be about 412 miles. And then another one from Darwin, Australia. Short wobble, notice the couch shaking while seated. Another one from the same location. Furniture shaking strong for 3 seconds and kept going for 20 seconds. Going to Google Earth, here you can see we got Australia, the Australian plate moving north. And we'll go to the location of this earthquake, of the 6.2, right there. And you can see how we got movement of the plate going northwest a little bit. More likely, it was caused by the movement of the Australian plate. Here on Geoscope, you can see here, in fact, the fault line. Yeah, it moved going north. Right there and right there. We got two different monitors for the fault planes, but both of them show the fault moving towards the north. And up here it shows it was a magnitude 6.2. Yep, earthquakes are increasing around the world. Also last night at about 10:55 p.m. Pacific Standard Time, there was a magnitude 4.6 earthquake near Port McNeil, Canada. 3 people so far have sent in reports saying they felt it. Going to Google Earth. All right, let's bring this out. You can see I got a fault line drawn out. Yep, this is probably the Explorer plate, part of the Juan de Fuca plate. Let me bring it out. You can see here how the Explorer plate is moving towards North America, and it's subducting. And then we got the Cascadia subduction zone. Let me bring it out farther. Yeah, it's just a matter of time before that one decides to rip open. No felt report sent in to EMSE. And they said it was 10 kilometers in depth. Now, they often put 10 kilometers when they just don't know. So they just, say, all right, 10 kilometers. So that would be about 6 miles in depth. This is on USGS's webpage. Why do so many earthquakes occur at a depth of 10 kilometers? 10 kilometers is a fixed depth. Sometimes data is too poor to compute a reliable depth for an earthquake. In such cases, the depth will be assigned as 10 kilometers. Why that number? In many areas around the world, reliable depths tend to average 10 kilometers or close to it. So if we don't know the depth, 10 kilometers is a reasonable guess. USGS uses 33 kilometers by increased understanding, indicating that 10 kilometers is more likely. In some areas like subduction zones are known to have many earthquakes much deeper than 10 kilometers. In those areas, a fixed depth would probably be appropriate. And you might find this interesting. A useful rule of thumb is that a reliable depth requires that the distance from the epicenter to the nearest station must be less than the depth of the earthquake. So if you're wondering why so many earthquakes are put at 10, that's because they're guessing. They just don't know. So what are your thoughts? Put those comments down below. Thank you very much for watching. Please share my videos. Make sure you're subscribed if you have subscribed. The AI for YouTube often unsubscribes people. And if you're not subscribed, please join our community. Thank you very much. Always be prepared for some sort of disaster. Could be like what happened in Ohio, the chemical explosion where people had to evacuate. Could be floods, could be tornadoes, and earthquakes. Yeah, you name it. It could be anything. Always be prepared. And as always, please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.